Hello there. Very good morning. You're watching Proactive London and news from Centamin this week because they reported lower gold production in the first quarter as planned while it takes over the running of the underground operations at the flagship Sukari mine there in Egypt. So Martin Horgan is joining us now, the Chief Executive Officer, to explain all of this and much more. So good to see you, Martin.
Good morning, Katie. Nice to meet you and thanks for having me today.
Nice to meet you too. So let's get started. Explain this announcement to us and where it places you going forward.
Thanks, Katie. I think, as you said in your preface there, that's exactly right. It was a good first quarter for us. I think we delivered into the plans that we set ourselves. I think importantly to start off with, it was a safe quarter. No LTIs reported and a good safety record. So that's always a good place to start from. And I think, as you say, the headline part of the first quarter was this transition from contract mining in the underground operations to bring that in-house and go owner-operated. A lot of work went into that. It's a big transition for us moving into those operations. The team had put a lot of work into fourth quarter last year preparing, and we executed the plans very well. Purchasing of the contractor equipment, transferring the staff across to ourselves, and then ramping back up after maintenance of the purchased equipment stores as well. Of course, as you'd expect, it's a fairly disruptive process. And so we did, of course, guide for a lower first quarter while we made this transition. And of course, importantly, we came in with the range we expected to. And of course, we were able to then reconfirm guidance for the full year as we now start to hit a more stronger Q2, Q3 into Q4 as well. So look, a good quarter executed in line with plans, down on Q4 as suspected, but really sets us up nicely now for the full year 2022.
All right. And you've announced that you've completed the transition to this owner operator in Sukari Underground. How is the company, how is it progressing with its capital projects and particularly your cost saving initiatives, would you say?
Yeah, that was also, it was a peak quarter for us in terms of the year's capital expenditure. It's about the most we're going to spend. Lots going on. And we've sort of flagged historically that this is a phase of sort of 12, 18 months of reinvestment in the asset after a very successful 10 years of operation. We're now looking to reposition the asset for the next 10 years and beyond. Things like the paste fill plant, which allow us to extract more of the underground gold in a safer way. That's progressed very well. It is on track for commissioning second half of this year. We've finished the third raise in our tailing storage facility. But I think the headline one, of course, which links into the cost saving initiatives as well, is around the construction of our 36 megawatt solar power plants as well. And that's moved on very, very nicely. We're well through the build process now. And that does remain to be on track for completion and commissioning second half of the year. And that's got huge implications. Certainly given inflationary pressures as we've seen around the oil price, is that at the moment will save us between $1 to $1.5 million per month in diesel costs as well. So a very good execution on the capital project side and very importantly keying into those future cost savings as we reposition the asset for the future.
Okay, let's talk more quickly about the exploration side of things because that's also commenced there at the Sukari accession. Maybe update on your progress and kind of across the broader portfolio as well.
Absolutely. So we've got sort of four now, actually, areas where we're looking at sort of exploration as a real driver of growth. Within the main ore body itself that we're mining, obviously, we're quite excited, as we flagged previously, around the potential for further growth in the underground. And really, that sort of underground growth, we've focused on two areas over the last sort of 6 months. One is the ongoing depth extension to the ore body. As we've said previously before, the ore body is not geologically constrained, it's drill constrained. We're looking to find those strike and depth extensions, and good work has continued on that basis. And then importantly, these high-grade bonanza zones, which we announced in December, these are these low tonnage but high-value, high-grade areas as well. And they've also been a focus as well. So good progress around the ore body extension work. Fantastically, we've actually about completed the first ever airborne geophysical survey in Egypt. It's something that's taken about a year to get organised. It was a new technique for the country. Lots of permissions, permitting, importation of equipment not seen before. We were able to complete that work. We've been successfully flying over most of April, and we've just about finished that airborne survey as well across the existing concession area. So that's hugely exciting. In conjunction with that airborne survey, we did have some new drill targets we generated last year. And those drill targets, we've completed the drilling programs from 10,000 metres. And we've started to receive the assays back and really pleased with the initial results from that as well. And expect to see those the balance of those assays coming in the second quarter. And then finally, away from the Sukari mine itself, within our broader Egyptian exploration portfolio, we're now just about ready to start that exploration work across the Egyptian desert licenses as well. That'll start post Ramadan in May. And very quickly pivoting to West Africa, the Doropo pre-feasibility study continues to move along at pace very nicely. Excellent progress there. Drilling pretty much complete now across the main ore bodies. A little bit of metallurgical drilling to be done, and that leaves the PFS on as well. So lots of ground to cover. We didn't talk too much about it in this release. What we decided to do is that later on this quarter, we'll make a standalone, fuller and sort of deeper dive into the exploration, where we'll map out this in great technical information for those investors interested later on in the quarter as well. But again, a hugely successful and very satisfying quarter on that front as well.
All right. Well, plenty of upcoming catalysts from the sound of things.
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right. Sounds good. All right. Thank you ever so much for joining us. That's Martin Horgan there, the Chief Executive Officer from Centamin here on Proactive London.